We talk a lot about research in India. We talk a lot about what scientists are doing. We have the best quality of scientists available who work globally on all levels of science development. But we don't see a new drug out of an Indian institute in India. Where do you think there is a gap where there is capability, but we are somewhere missing out on the line?
So, thank you for that question. And I think the first thing is that, you know, when most people think about research, they probably think about products.
Mm.
And therefore, it's quite natural to want to see a new drug, a new vaccine, and a new diagnostic. And that's true, that we should aim to do all of those things.
Mm.
But in order to get a new drug, you need a whole chain, what we call as the innovation value chain, you know, right from the time when a scientist actually has an initial discovery in the lab, when they find out some molecular pathway and a drug target. And from there, then, you know, you have to do a lot of work, preclinical work initially, to find out whether that particular drug target, you can find a molecule to work on that. And then once you have a molecule, then you do toxicity studies, you look at to make sure that it's a safe, it would be safe, that it's druggable. And then you take it into animal studies. And then finally, after having done all of that, it comes into human studies, and then it goes through phase 1 to look at safety, clinical trials, and then phase 2 and 3. Now, it's been estimated that out of every 1,000 molecules that a scientist discovers and thinks could become a new drug, only one actually makes it past all these barriers. So it's not only a question of financial resources that somebody has to invest. You invest in 1,000, you'll get one at the end. But you also need to make sure that the scientist who does the initial discovery is not the person who will be able to take it through the other steps. So you need pharmacologists, you need organic chemists, you need biochemists, and then you need people with expertise in doing animal studies, toxicology studies. You need good animal facilities to do that. And then you know, pharmacokinetics, and then finally you need people with a good clinical trial experience who can do this. So that is where I think we have not been able to create that system where there is a seamless flow and there's synergy and collaboration between these different groups. And ultimately, you need a industrial a pharma partner. You need a commercial partner because otherwise this product is never going to find its way into market. So now there are several initiatives by the Government of India, the Department of Biotechnology, the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR, and the ICMR have really started working together to see how can we collaborate on academia, public, private, and industry partnerships in order to actually move a product, whether it's a vaccine or whether it's a drug candidate.
So are we strong enough as far as basic research is concerned? Are we funding enough of basic research in India?
I think we have very strong basic science research organizations, and there's a lot of discoveries being made on a daily basis. So I think if we are able to do this strengthening of the chain along the way, then we'll actually be able to take those basic science discoveries and try and move them through, because otherwise most of them are just getting lost because the scientists who make those initial discoveries are not able to take them,
move it on to the next level. And industry academia collaboration is also not much seen in India. You know, in states, in countries like US and all, it's an ecosystem. It's a thriving ecosystem where drugs are being taken to the market by, or at least the research is taken forward by private companies as well in the industry. Do you think there is a lack of policy initiative on that part, or the market dynamics for the industry doesn't support them? Where do you think this gap is?
Yes, I think it's a bit of everything. The first thing is that R&D for new drugs, diagnostics and vaccines is a risky business. And therefore, there's a risk in investment. Now, a company, particularly if it's a small to medium-sized company, would not want to take major risks. They would like to use their funds to ensure that they are able to get a product which is marketed and that they get returns, or their shareholders get returns. So if you look at the US, and you mentioned that they've been very successful, the initial risky investment is all by government. So it's the NIH, which has a budget of about $30 billion, which invests in the basic science, and then which allows scientists to spin off companies or to sell their intellectual property to a company that would then, once the company knows that yes, this product has already been brought to a certain stage by scientists, now all they have to do is, you know, take it and upscale the whole thing and manufacture it at GMP and then be able to market it.
So as a country, are we not investing enough from the government side on basic research then?
We need to invest more in basic research, but now I think the policy environment has also taken cognizance of these barriers that we have, and so a lot of attempts, a lot of work is being done to ease these barriers. On the regulatory side, for example, we used to take a long time to give approval for a new drug product that wanted to do clinical trial in India, and there were a lot of delays, and our companies did suffer as a result. Now the timelines have been shortened, processes have been streamlined, everything is online, you know, and so the DCGI's office, for example, now has set timelines for each process. And so you know that if you apply today, within 3 months you're going to get. So that's made a big difference. Where we are still need to strengthen further is in the area of clinical trials. We don't have very good phase one trial sites in the country, so most companies are still forced to go outside. Same is true for animal studies as well, and for the phase one human trials. The phase two and three we're able to do quite comfortably, though we need to again build up more sites so that many more trials can be happening simultaneously.
Okay. Any work that is being done from ICMR side to push on the clinical trials?
Yes. So we are actually in the process of now identifying several medical college institutions. It could be both in the private and the public sector, which have the potential and the capability to become trial sites. The phase one trial sites, they may be only one or two to begin with in the country, because they are require a heavy investment both in terms of infrastructure and training of human resources and dedicated staff. And they have to be in hospitals which have ICUs and which can really take care of patients very well. For phase two and three, you need different kinds of capacities. So we're in the process of developing that. And the Department of Biotechnology also recently has launched this biopharma mission, which is a partnership with the World Bank to try to speed in product development, especially in the area of vaccines for a few identified diseases and biosimilars. So they also have this mandate to strengthen clinical trial capacity. So I think in the next few years, we'll see a lot of that happening.
But would that be for the government agencies working in this sort of field, or will it also be open for private companies who are doing research in these fields to use those facilities?
Yes, it will be open for private also, because without private, we really can't to make new products. I think we need to realize that. So there is no other way except for government and private to work together.
And yes, the investment, initial investment of setting up the phase one trial infrastructure would come in from the government.
Could come in from ICMR, government, but we're also looking at partnerships.
Okay.
At public-private partnerships to do this.